Hello, fellow Southern Cameroonians. My name is Solomon Amabo. I'm a rights media practitioner and a Southern Cameroonian in good standing. I'm coming to thank all our people for what they have been doing for the past 8 to 10 months to resist oppression and brutality from Yaoundé. And as time goes on, I encourage many of our people to come up and speak up against any form of oppression. My message is very simple. Our people must first understand that we are in a peaceful resistance. We need no violence. We want to limit the casualties. We want to thank all those who have lost their lives, those who have been in jail, just for the struggle for the liberation of the Southern Cameroons. As I said a while ago, this is the time we have to show a lot of unity in the way we fight. It is a time we have to give our respect to the Governing Council and to all the other liberation movements, MORIST, the SCYL, Ambazonia, SCAPO, the SCNC, and all other people who are fighting to ensure that we Southern Cameroonians are treated with respect and with dignity. Now, I want to talk about particularly the issue of school resumption. We have said there should be no school in the Southern Cameroons. No school at all. All the schools should remain shut down. This is to demand for the release of all our people who are in the bunkers of Yaoundé. And if Yaoundé thinks we are joking, then they should rethink again. We want to see everybody, to the last person, Patrick Ndango and all others, pen parents. You can't be keeping teachers in jail and asking schools to resume. Secondly, we wanted to see legal and educational reforms. All those cosmetic decrees and whatsoever are not the reforms we want. They must do the reforms. We have not even thinking about those who are outside, those who are on exile, who have left their families, those who are in jail, who takes care of their families. There should be no school, and anybody taking the risk to go to school should know that if anything happens to you, you will simply be on your own. I equally want to talk to our Francophone brothers and sisters. Mes chers frères et sœurs francophones, nous avons décidé, nous, les habitants du Southern Cameroons, qu'il n'y aura pas école cette année 2017-2018. Nous avons instauré les villes mortes de lundi à mercredi entre 6h et 18h. Donc nous voulons dire à tous les parents, c'est mieux de garder vos enfants à la maison. Ne prenez pas les risques d'envoyer vos enfants à l'école. Vous avez vu ce qui s'est passé à Limbé dernièrement au Collège Espoir. Les gens sont mécontents. Ils ont été torturés, ils ont été abusés. Et ils demandent justice. C'est pour ça qu'on a demandé d'arrêter les cours. Nous savons que c'est important d'envoyer les enfants à l'école. Mais il faut comprendre une chose. La première chose qui est importante, c'est d'abord la vie. Deuxièmement, la liberté de s'exprimer et de marcher. Tant que nous n'avons pas ça, les écoles doivent rester fermées. Nous voyons comment certaines personnes vont dans les chaînes de télé, les radios pour nous insulter. Nous sommes les sécessionnistes, nous sommes les extrémistes. Mais on est en train de tirer dessus des gens à bout portant. On a tué 7 personnes. D'autres ont été incarcérés. Donc, tous ceux qui nous insultent là, nous luttons pour notre liberté et nous allons nous combattre jusqu'à la dernière énergie. Nous allons jusqu'au bout. Donc, respecter les vies mortes, c'est très important. Ne prenez pas le risque. Si le Southern Cameroun ne vous plaît plus, quittez la zone. Envoyez vos enfants ailleurs. L'État doit comprendre que les anglophones en ont marre. Nous ne sommes pas leurs esclaves. C'est fini cette dictature. On ne peut pas nous gouverner sans notre consentement. Nous devons avoir le droit d'exprimer notre mécontentement par rapport à la manière dont nous sommes gérés. Ça ne se passera plus comme avant. A priori, l'État doit organiser un référendum pour que nous décidions. Cette affaire doit être résolue une fois pour toutes. Et nous n'allons pas reculer, nous allons jusqu'au bout. Donc respectez les villes mortes, Gardez vos enfants à la maison, gardez la nourriture, c'est ce qui est le plus important pour l'instant. I want to talk to our other comrades who just left jail. They should maintain calm and stay away from trouble. I can't equally go without talking to our people who are on the ground, our foot soldiers. Now, for all Wunawuna Day, for Limbe, for Kumba, for everywhere, I come na for tell una see, when I don't see what it happen with people. When I don't see how they can't catch man for a house, carry, go make 8 months, when I see Zama, he chop na rice and granite soup. Now Zama will be the help for fix Limbe. They only did the thief money. They catch him, go put him for prison. When I don't see even cripple for Bamenda, they go put them for prison. 8 months so they waste their time. This will not be the first time. And we tell the government, so they get for liberate all our people, until the last man, Celestin Atanga, Patrick Dango, all the people them, Mancho BBC in particular, they must release all our people. And may all Anglophones, they know, we know the joke. That thing when they say ghost town, all man must respect ghost town. It is not mandatory. Because now the only peaceful way we get for resist the oppression, the torture of our people, because you can take man so carry go yaundi, torture him, so and they don't die. Who go pay for other people they don't die? So now me I come for tell what people then say, the resistance just start. And make we respect ghost towns, keep chop for your house. Sometimes go reach up the ghost town go be in 1 week. When I say when I know, they don't send army them, gendarme them. Plenty they flop for all side for kill people them. Inside taxi, they stay inside. Any place you want go, they inside. Una get for stay safe, make we reduce the rate at which they arrest our people. It be very sickening. Say they catch even man way na cripple, go put it for prison for 8 months, and then they sign decree, make it come out. We get for resist, we get for stop violence. The one be very important. We don't get for the fight ourselves. Even man way they oppose the struggle, una no hate. As una they show you love, na so small sense it enter for their head. So one day they come say we'll be extremist, we'll be terrorist. We'll be terrorist if they take mango for court. We don't take government, go for African Commission. 2009, they say government come for discussion. Till today, government no one talk. So we don't decide to say we the people. We say they no go rule we again without our consent. At best, we'll get our freedom, we'll get our independence because this torture, it don't go on. Make a tell on what happened with me for 2011. I go Boya. We go cover event for this very Southern Cameroon issue. I reach for front Molanjo a door with the room, put BB chain for the gendarme. They just come out, beat me. Till today I talk so my ear get problem. I need a ear with the one ear. They beat me like who give them the right to be beating people? We are saying that the violence on our people has gotten to a point where we have to make it to stop. And we go for stop school. Any man will go school now at a risk. Because when they see the kind of thing the way they come out, they do, you go to school, say so you first come to do the waiting. No school, no get for B. Until, so get ghost town, serious ghost town. We don't want to see no man for street. All man stay inside house. When the army, they go shit on, they tire, they go withdraw them from our territory. We cannot go to school, we army them all over the place. What are they doing on Southern Cameroon territory? Is that the way you govern the people? No. I go come more and more often for tell us that the time this we go give our support for the governing council for His Excellency Sisiku Ayuk Tabe. He go tell you what to do. For now, decision I say 3 days where he go pass mami wadu and papa and uncle wata ghost town. We don't want to see fly for outside. If you go outside, they kill you. Now you know. Now they don't kill Akum Julius, kill other people them. We go for limit the death of our people. Fight these people in a more peaceful and disciplined way and in unity. Make una know say United Nations it watch with it go on. And if school no start, United Nations will ask them why school no start. They go for come to dialogue, discuss with we. We are not animals, we are not terrorists. We are telling them that we are the minority and our rights must be respected. Fellow comrades, I've just come say make a discuss with una. I would come time to talk to Una and make more other Anglophones. We go for come out. If we do with 8 million, we go for come out and we 2 million. Make the no say we are no longer joking. and we are very serious. Stay at home, be disciplined, respect ghost town. At the top of that taxi pool for Limbe, in particular, Limbe, Boya, Tiko, Mutengene. Una respect ghost town. Any man where he get picking, keep him for house. No fee station, not the day for day, they will guard you for house, guard you everywhere. No. Respect the laws of the land and make we take this struggle to a logical end. Happy Sunday. God bless all of you. God bless the Southern Cameroons. We are marching on. We are moving to get our freedom. Thank you very much, fellow comrades. A luta continua. The struggle continues. Victoria is certa. The victory is certain. Have a great day, fellow comrades.